You're watching a film called Junior Prom from 1946. It stars a bunch of actors known as the Teenagers. It was the first in a series of seven films made between 1946 and 1948. These were the comic adventures of a group of high school students. They sing, they dance, and they hang out in a cafeteria in which they call the Teen Canteen. Like many out there, I became familiar with this series of films from Riff Tracks with the wonderful and hilarious commentary by Mary Jo Peel and Bridget Jones Nelson. So far, they've done four of the seven teenager films. These so-called teenagers were Freddie Stewart, age 21, Judy Clark, age 25, Noelle Neal, age 26, Jackie Moran, age 23, Warren Mills, age 20, June Prezer, age 28, and Frankie Darro, age 29. Each one of these actors had an interesting story. In part two of The Teenagers, I'm going to look at the actor Frank Darro. Frank had an extremely interesting life. By the time he made this film, the 29-year-old had been acting for 25 years, from the Flying Johnsons to child actor, stuntman, adult actor, and then, well, there was the Troubles. The thing about this biography, however, is that I could find very few interviews with Frankie himself, so I will have to do the best I can without the actor's own words. Frankie was born Frank Johnson Jr. on December 22, 1917 in Chicago, Illinois. His parents were Frank Johnson Sr. and Ada Johnson. They were part of an act called the Flying Johnsons, an acrobatic and tightrope walking act with a Sells Flolo circus. The Flying Johnsons were Frank, Ada, and a mysterious man who might have been named Giovanni or maybe Eldolf Jell. We'll get back to them a little later. The Flying Johnsons were visiting Chicago when Frank Sr. was born. Frank Jr. was quickly brought into the act, but he had a problem, a fear of heights. His father, Frank Sr., wouldn't hear of this and began trying to get his infant son to overcome his fears. Junior wasn't even 4 years old yet. Diana Sahara Carey, who was known as Baby Peggy, one of the first child stars in Hollywood, wrote in her autobiography, "The fear did not go away, but Frankie forced it to retreat to a secret place inside himself where it could no longer be seen or its existence even sensed by his domineering father." Meanwhile, Frankie added tumbling and acrobatics to his skills. Soon he knew his father would invite him to climb the tall ladder to the platform at the top of the tent from which his father, his mother, and a new Italian partner whirled through their sensational routines. But before the child had a chance to perform on the high wire, the act came to an end. The circus was in Long Beach, California, when his mother had a complete nervous breakdown. Without the circus, his parents started performing in vaudeville, and the little 4-year-old Frankie, who was now using the last name Darro, found his own way to earn a little cash. Gives benefit for himself, after show. For the purpose of obtaining some money for his own use, little Frankie Darro, 4-year-old son of Mr. and Mrs. Frank Darro, acrobats appearing on the vaudeville on the bill of the Atkins Theater last night, proceeded to give a performance in the lobby of the theater while his parents were performing on the stage. The youngster did some handsprings, walked on his hands, and other acrobatic stunts for the benefit of the patrons entering the theater, and as a result, took up a collection which netted him a tidy sum. Frankie has been playing in opposition to his parents in several towns he has visited recently, and has been scoring a hit. In an interview with Frankie from Picture Play magazine from March of 1935, Frankie said, "Mother and Dad were theatrical people and traveled all over the vaudeville circuit. Of course, they took me along. Well, I was what they called a cute little boy. Gee, I hated that. I suppose most parents like to dress a kid up and have people admire him. But that's not all. I had long yellow curls. It was terrible. I got so sick of those curls that one day I went into a vacant dressing room and took a pair of shears. I had plenty of time, so I cut my hair clean down to the skin. Smack bareheaded I was. Then my hair started to grow in, and it grew in black, just like it is now. Funny, huh?" Now, it's not known why the family began using the name Darro. His father had used that same stage name early on in his own vaudeville career. Frank Sr. found work in films, using his acrobatic skills to be a stuntman. But what was really needed in Hollywood at the time were children who could not only act, but do their own stunts. Hey, this was long before child labor laws. Frank Sr. had got to know Ralph Ince. Ralph was an American pioneer film actor, director, and screenwriter during the early silent film era. And it was through Ince that Dad got little Frankie some acting work. He was only 6 when he acted in the 1924 film Judgment of the Storm, and he was almost an instant success. The child had the looks, the acting ability, and was totally comfortable in front of the camera, and, like I said, could do his own stunts. Jackie Coogan's rival. Photo shows Frankie Darro, child movie star with Chicky Mason on the beach at Pacific City, California. Frankie played the title character in his next film, Half a Dollar Bill. Half a Dollar Bill is new Metro Gaff special. Half a Dollar Bill, Max Graff's new production from Metro Release that has been announced to be shown next week at the Constantine Theater, is said to be one of the finest sea stories ever screened. It not only has a cast of such prominent players as Anna Q. Nielsen, William Carlton, Raymond Hatton, Michael Lewis, George McQuarrie, and Alec B. Francis, but it introduces a new juvenile actor in 4-year-old Frankie Darro, who gives an exceptional performance as the young boy who is nicknamed Half a Dollar Bill because, as a baby, he's found abandoned with a torn dollar bill pinned to him. The title role of the story has been entrusted to little Frankie Darro, the 4-year-old mite, who completely captivates the hearts of this audience, as do 2 unusual dogs who appear prominently in the telling of this tale. Perilous stunt by 4-year-old. That sequence is out. There isn't any such boy, said W.H. Van Dyke when he first read the script of Half a Dollar Bill and found it called for a 4-year-old to run out on the bowsprit of a ship plunging through a gale, swept there for a moment over the water, then lose his balance and hang by a rope with the waves drenching him at every roll of the ship. Van Dyke said it couldn't be done by any boy. That was before he met little Frankie Darro. The bowsprit and rope stunts was pie to Frankie, who received gymnastics training from his parents, the balancing Darros, from his infancy. Frank Coughlin Jr., another very popular child star of the time, who was known as Junior Coughlin, said this to Frankie in the book 15 Minutes With, 40 Years of Interviews by G. Michael Dobbs. Oh, Frankie was a real character. He was raised in a circus atmosphere by his parents. He was a marvelous acrobat. By the age of 4, he could do great tricks. He was a little on the coarser side than some of the other kids that were around the studio, but he was a marvelous guy. We worked in a lot of films together. He was just an all-around good guy. By the time he was 7, little Frankie Darro was a star and getting great reviews. This continued on for the next few years. He made 6 films in 1924, 12 films in 1925, 15 films in 1936, 12 films in 1937, and 7 films in 1938. This included a series of films with Western star Tom Tyler. Tyler was born Vincent Markowski on August 9, 1903. He was an American actor known for his leading roles in low-budget Western films in both the silent and sound era. Tom and Frankie would make at least 24 films together. Frankie Darro is promising youngster. Little Frankie Darro, who plays an important role in Racing for Life at the Winter Garden, is one of those ambitious youngsters who possess some real histrionic ability. Cast with Eva Novak, William Fairbanks, and an all-star cast of able screen players, Frankie does some things that will make you hold onto your seat for fear that the worst might happen to him. He is well-trained and has an ambitious program for himself as to what sort of an actor he will be when he grows to manhood. Like other child actors, he is very popular. At the Moon! Little Frankie Darro has an important role in The Phantom Express, the railroad story with a new twist that comes to the Moon Theater for a 4-day run next Sunday, is one of the brightest and most experienced child actors on the screen. He is only 6 years old now and has been on the stage and in vaudeville since he was 2. He appears in numerous pictures, always taking parts that require real work. His part in The Phantom Express gives him a splendid opportunity to show what a clever little chap he is. This picture will be shown with 5 new acts of vaudeville. Now, all was going great for Frankie. He was making about $300 a week as a working actor in low-budget films. That's equal to over $5,000 in today's money. And as you might imagine, when that much money is being made by an 11-year-old child, things can go wrong. In 1928, his career was put on hold. His parents, who were now separated, began battling for custody. And it wasn't just Frank Sr. and Ada, but also Frankie's aunt, Beatrice Walton, who was battling for Frankie, or Frankie's money. Film prodigy barred in court. Frankie Darro, child actor, gambles with elevator operator as parents and aunts wrangle over custody and mother surprises papa on parentage. Although Frankie Darro, child star of the screen, was one of the parties most interested in the proceedings in Judge Desmond's court yesterday, he was not allowed to listen to them. The things to be discussed were not fit for young ears, Judge Desmond ruled. So Frankie stayed out in the corridor and won a dime from the elevator operator by excelling the later in a dance contest. In the courtroom, 3 persons, Frankie's mother, his father, and his aunt, contended for his custody. Beatrice Walton, the aunt, is in charge of the boy under a temporary court order and wants to keep him. She inserts that Mrs. Ada Johnson, the mother, is a profligate and is unfit to care for him. Mrs. Johnson, represented by attorney Roger Machetti, denies these charges. Frank Johnson, former husband of Mrs. Johnson, represented by attorney Ben Gray, declared the boy's mother had sent him on the streets of Hollywood to sell papers, although he was earning as much as $300 a week in pictures, having squandered his earnings. Mrs. Johnson then threw a surprise into the proceedings by relating calmly that Johnson was not a party of interest. She said he's not the boy's father anyway. Johnson retorted that he was indeed surprised by the assertion, as it was the first intimation of such a state of affairs he has received in the 8 years since Frankie was born. Now, I have read that there are many who think the mysterious Giovanni, the third member of the Flying Johnsons, was the actual father. But part of the court order complaint states, It was alleged by the applicant, testified by her, and is here insisted, that while still an unmarried woman and prior to her illicit companionship and domicile with the respondent, she committed acts of adultery with one Adolf Gell, as a result of which the minor in controversy was born to her. That Frank Johnson was not its father, that she had not so considered him nor held him out to others. Another part of the court paper that I found interesting stated that it was averted that owing to habitual intemperance, depravity, and associations with improper persons, practices of immoral acts, and the use of degrading language in the immediate presence of her child, the said Ada Johnson is an unfit and improper person to have care, custody, and control, that its welfare was imperiled, and that unless the environment and personal care of said minor should be improved, a valuable contract of employment would be canceled and its estate entirely dissipated. Custody of child actor brings on marital warfare, with one court holding the hearings into the question of the custody of Frankie Darro, child actor. His mother, Mrs. Ada Darro Johnson, today appeared in another court to file a divorce complaint against Frank Johnson. She charged her husband, whom she testified in the custody hearing was not the father of her child actor's son, with beating her and employing other cruelties. Johnson, contesting the divorce action, filed a general denial of his wife's charges and made a counter-allegation that Mrs. Johnson staged wild parties in their Beverly Hills home. Both Johnson and his wife, in their divorce complaints, stated that there were no children from the marriage. The divorce hearing is set for November 27th, the custody hearing in which Mrs. Johnson seeks sole custody of Frank Darro and his earnings was continued until next Thursday. In these, Johnson has sought to retain a share of the custody of the child. Child actor to be given a life chance. The probate court ruled today that Frankie Darro, 9-year-old film actor who earns $300 a week, is to be given the chance in life to which he is entitled and which has been denied him thus far. The court ruling stated, there is a boy far above the average. He can earn $300 a week. Testimony shows that none of this has been saved so far for his future. I am going to give him the chance he is entitled to. I shall order that neither party will have custody, but will appoint a third party whom I know will take him into his home and give him his chance. Frankie Darro case decided. Child actor placed in care of neutral party. Attorney for mother tells plans for appeal. Court urges boy to be taken out of film work. Screen juvenile's father divorced. Charging his wife had staged wild drinking parties and had informed him that she was in love with another man, Frank Johnson today secured a divorce before Judge K.S. Mahan from Alda Johnson, mother of Frank Darro, screen juvenile. And as you can imagine, this went on for some time with appeals and such. And it was probably a good thing that his parents got divorced. It didn't seem like all that healthy of a relationship. Frankie only appeared in a few films in 1929, most probably shot before The Trouble. One film that was released was The Rainbow Man, his first sound movie. The 12-year-old was able to do what others failed to do, and that's make the transition from silent to sound. It wasn't until 1931 that his film career got back on track. One of the first films he appeared in was The Public Enemy with James Cagney and Jean Harlow. He played Edward Wood's character, Matt Doyle, as a youngster.
Hello, Tommy.
Hello.
Dan Reed?
Come on, Matt. We got business.
Give us a little kiss, huh?
That's what you get for fooling with women.
Here you go, boy. Stop, I say. Stop that. Officer, get those boys.
Say, maybe you don't know how to shoot a gun. No, I reckon it wasn't you that killed my brother. Well, haven't you got anything to say? Easy now, son, easy. Let's stop scrapping and talk things over.
And then we'll branch out.
Sure, we'll have buses with beds in them. You know, the kind that go from here to New York. Ain't that right, Tony?
You betcha my life.
There's the phone.
So you think I'm ugly?
No, you're not ugly. But as for Morania, well...
Like Alice in Wonderland. Off with her heads and all such tripe.
What would you say if I followed the plan of your ugly duchess and actually ordered your heads removed?
I'd say you better look out for Jean when he heard about it.
And what would your Gene do?
He'd telephone the president. Before you could wink an eye, there'd be a regiment of artillery or knocking the top off this palace.
Silence!
He also starred in the 12-chapter mascot serial, The Lightning Warrior, billed second under the dog Rin Tin Tin. And finally, in March of 1932, the saga of his guardianship came to an end. Frankie, now 14 years old, went in front of a judge and asked if he could live with his father, and the judge agreed. Frankie Darro, 14-year-old motion picture actor, went before Superior Judge Bush yesterday, where his father, Frank Darro, was appointed as his new guardian. "Well, I certainly hope you make a lot of money this year," Judge Bush declared. "Oh boy," exclaimed the yellow-sweatered Frankie, "so do I." Frankie signed a contract with Mascot Pictures for $50 a week. While it wasn't the $300 he was once paid, it was still equal to a little over $1,000 in today's money. Not bad. Mascot Pictures Corporation was a small American film company of the 1920s and 30s, best known for producing and distributing film serials and B-Westerns. Frankie Darro declines double. When Frankie Darro was engaged to support Lane Chandler in the Western film The Cheyenne Cyclone, the producer looked around for a double, not wishing to risk the boy star's life in the hazardous stunts demanded by director Armand Schaefer. Learning this, Frankie hunted up the producer and laid down the edict. Either he does his own stunts or he would walk off the picture. After fruitless argument, Frank was given his way and proceeded to show the whole world that no cowboy, big or little, has anything on him. Mounted on a big white horse, this youth rode right away from the posse and gave Lane Chandler and the gallant Raven all they could do to ride him down. In addition, he made even the hardened cowboys gasp at some of the wild Pony Express mounts and dismounts. Every boy in America will be thrilled by the exploits of this youngster. There was a small incident when Frankie was 16 involving a car accident. He was driving with fellow actor and friend Leanne Holmes. The two ended up in court. Eventually, however, the friends settled their differences. He was still acting regularly and appeared again with James Cagney in 1933 in the film The Mayor of Hell. And as he approached adulthood, he began insisting people call him Frank. I don't think that name change took. In 1934, there was something called the Frankie Darro Stamp Club. And although Frankie had become an adult, he remained small in height. He would stop growing at 5'3", and this led to the type of role that would dominate his later career, playing a horse jockey. Frankie Darro has a leading role. Frankie Darro, who plays one of the lead roles in the mascot picture Burn 'em Up Barnes, coming to the Grand Theater Friday, Saturday, when not working, can be found standing behind the director watching every move he makes. Although only 17, Frankie predicts that he will be a director someday and is constantly learning how it's done. And you know you've made it in Hollywood when rumors of who you are dating appear in the paper. Frankie Darro, the former kid actor, will wed Virginia Garland. Frankie and Virginia were never married. And aren't Dixie Dunbar and Frankie Darro a new twosome? They were at Kerwin's merry-go-round. Frankie, by the way, is the first beau Dixie ever had who was anywhere near her size.
Those convicts. We gotta get there right away. They got her at the Morris cabin.
We'll get the police.
We haven't got time for that. You've gotta go.
They got my fool. Those men are killers. I'm not going there.
But listen. All right, Dexter. You're going to that cabin with me right now.
Don't pay any attention to him, Tom. He just read out on the account of that, you know.
Morning.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Renderberry.
Well, here goes my appetite.
What's the idea of trying to beat up a kid like this? Shame on you. Now, Michael, me lad, run along and peddle your papers.
And let that be a lesson to you, Barney, me lad. It's a good thing for you O'Reilly come along when he did, you big palooka.
Oh, my mush again. What is this, the army?
I wish you were in it.
Still wish I was in it. Let me see this fourth page. Oh, society women.
They're going to pull a job tonight and I'm supposed to beat it. I'll meet you in the filling station at 87th and Norton. You tell Eddie that I said he was the talk.
No, no, stupid. You got the wrong number.
Hi, boys. Kid.
Boys,
this is Tommy Ryan. I'm going to drive one of the cars for you.
And sadly, on March 18th, 1937, Frankie's mother, Ada, passed away at 40 years old. The causes were unknown. And in July of 1938, he had a new stepmother. Frankie Darro, whose screen specialty is jockeys, has a new stepmother. His father, Frankie Darro Johnson, was just wed to Rose Rizzo, formerly an entertainer of the Big Tops. The courts gave Frankie Darro the best Christmas present of his life yesterday on his 21st birthday when he became the guardian of his own pocketbook. For years, Frankie has been going through an experience similar to Jackie Coogan with his parents squabbling over his earnings, at least until the death of his mother 6 years ago. In July of 1939, Frankie married Aloha Ray. Apparently, they were childhood sweethearts.